Most embarrassing moment happened on my first day as a flight attendant, and it happened because so when you go through training, you get trained on a ton of things. Training is 6 weeks at the airline I flew for, and everything goes so fast and everything's brand new, so you're like just trying to be like a sponge and absorb everything. Things that someone else normally does. as yourself. And one of those things is closing the airplane door. Normally, that's a two-person job. There's the flight attendant on the inside closing the door, and there's a customer service agent on the outside of the door helping the door close. But in the smaller stations, sometimes you just do that yourself. And this is my first time closing the airplane door unassisted. So, hang on, I just gotta spray this really quick. So, this particular station was Barrow, Alaska. And it's way, way out there. And it can get very, very cold there. And on this day, it was extremely cold. It was negative, like 30 something. So, usually when you make a stop, you're on the ground for at least an hour, sometimes a bit longer. And it had been, you know, about an hour. We had deplaned, loaded new passengers. And it's important to note, this airplane was another one of those airplanes, a combi airplane, half passenger, half cargo. And that day I was working the position that sits near the flight deck with the cargo. And so I go to close the door, and I'm so focused on doing, you know, door closure procedure correctly, that I did not think about the fact that the door had been sitting outside in negative 30 something degree weather for over an hour. So it's the door handle is freezing cold, and I did not have gloves on. So I go to close this door. I've got my hands on the handle, and I close it, and I try to take my hands off of the handle, and my hands are stuck to the handle, like both of my palms are completely stuck. So I tell the pilots, I'm like, I have a problem. And they come out and they try pouring hot water on my hands to try and get them unstuck, and my hands do come off. However, all of the skin from both my palms is stuck to the door. So, the rest of the flight I spent scraping my dead skin off of the door handle and wearing gloves with like Neosporin inside to help my poor hands. And the pilot just goes, "Well, I guess you won't forget your gloves again." Nope. Never did forget my gloves again. So that was really fun. These are the things that they don't tell you in training. So then, my next one, I had been flying just under a year at this point, and when you're new, sometimes even like 5 or 6 years in, depends on your airline, you're on what's called reserve, so you just have days that you're on call and you wait around waiting for them to assign you a trip. And some of those days you are on call, you are on what is called airport standby. So you actually wait around at the airport for a set amount of time in case they have a trip that they need someone to work immediately. So I was on airport standby, and it had been like, at the time it was, airport standby was 4 hours, and it had been like 3 hours and 50 something minutes. So I'm thinking like, okay, I'm not gonna get used today, I'm gonna get to go home. And I won't have gosh, I have this hot chocolate now, and I've got all my bags, and I have to carry my bags, and the airplane that I was gonna be flying on was one where there's no gate. You have to walk out on the ground and then walk upstairs to get to the plane. And I was like, great, like now I've got this hot chocolate and I have to carry my bags up the stairs. So I decided in my infinite wisdom to chug this hot chocolate because I'm like, this Starbucks hot chocolate is expensive. I'm not throwing this away. So I chug it. Oh, when I tell you, I have never been more sick in my life. Oh my gosh, it was awful. Like, I was flying in the Arctic in Alaska, and it was, of course, a day which was super, super bumpy. So not only have I got this hot chocolate sitting in my gut like a brick, it's super, super bumpy, super turbulent. Fortunately, I was again on the combi and I got to be the position where you sit up front with the cargo. So you're not really doing much. You're basically sitting there in order to tell the pilots if the cargo catches on fire. Which obviously is an extremely rare occurrence. So I'm sicker than I've ever been. I've thrown up probably 8 times. And the pilots come out of the flight deck to use the bathroom, and I've literally got my face pressed up against the side of the airplane because it's cold. And I'm just got my face. I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm sweating. Everything smells like throw up. And the pilots are like, you don't look very good. And I'm like, yeah, I feel even worse than I look. So, lesson learned, do not ever chug Starbucks peppermint hot chocolates. That is a terrible idea. Embarrassing moment happened when I'd been flying like 4 years. And had gone to this new hotel on a layover because the hotel that the crew used to stay at, they were doing a lot of construction, so they moved us to a different hotel for like a few months while the construction was happening at the one we normally stay at. And this hotel was in San Francisco. And it's the biggest hotel I've ever been in. Like, it's like a city inside of this hotel. It's so big. And I actually got lost. Like, I went into my room when we got there, and I slept for ever. I mean, I slept probably like 14 hours because I was so tired. So on that whole layover, I never left my room. I just went in there, and when I went up there, I followed my crew, like, because all of our rooms were in a row. And so I wasn't really paying attention. I was just following the person that was in front of me. And so I wake up and I'm getting dressed, getting ready. I was kind of in a hurry because I woke up late. And I run out of my room and I'm looking around and I'm like, I don't recognize any of this. Like, where is the lobby? How do I get to the lobby? No idea. I'm walking around, and at this point, I'm starting to get nervous because is supposed to be leaving, which, like, they're not gonna leave without me because they can't go anywhere without their fourth crew member. But obviously I'm making everybody late now because I'm lost. And I'm crying at this point. I'm panicking. I'm trying to find anybody who can tell me how to get to the lobby. And all of a sudden I see two of my crew members. They're running down the hall and they're like, they're not mad or anything. They're literally looking at me like, why are you crying? Are you okay? What's happening? And I'm like, I'm so lost. I can't find the lobby. And they were like, it's okay. Don't panic. We know how to get back. You guys, I felt like I was in The Shining. I was like, the walls are closing in. The creepy murder twins are coming. No, because literally I get down to the van and the pilots are like, what happened? Are you okay? Like, did something happen? And I'm like, no, I just got lost inside of a hotel. So yeah, that was not one of my finer moments. We weren't even late. Like, when we got to the airport and got to the plane, we were still like 20 minutes earlier than we had to be there, so it was okay. Was fine, but I'm kind of a panicker, like, especially stuff like that. I do not like, you know, like making other people late or like being irresponsible, like not showing up when I'm supposed to be somewhere. That is just like one of the worst things for me. That sends my anxiety like through the roof. I always like to leave like early for things, you know. Oh, before I do this, I'm gonna spray my face. I've never been back to that hotel. I never want to go back to that hotel. It was so stressful, and I never want to think about ever having to figure out my way through that hotel ever again. There was another hotel in Louisiana, in New Orleans, where we stayed, that was so big. It was massive. There were like seven different banks of elevators to go to all the different floors. And you had to ride, you know, like a particular elevator to get to the floor you needed to go. You couldn't just get on any elevator. However, at that hotel, everything was way better marked. Like, there were instructions for how to get everywhere, like signs overhead, and everything was labeled really well. So I didn't have half the amount of trouble at that one. San Francisco one, whew, that was bad. Okay, so the next most embarrassing moment happened in Fairbanks, because it also gets very cold in Fairbanks, and this was in the dead of winter. And I've been flying like all day, and my trip had been changed like so many times, and so I wasn't even supposed to be in Fairbanks. I was supposed to be in Hawaii, but that flight canceled, so I ended up in Fairbanks. And I was so hungry, like unbelievably hungry. And place that was so good up there, and they were open late, which is when we got there really late. And I was like, okay, this is perfect, like I can go get something to eat, because at this Thai restaurant they make some gluten-free options. And there's like a little bar in the lobby area at that hotel. And they were sitting down there having like snacks. And here I go, I'm walking, I'm headed out outside, and the one pilot goes, "Where are you going?" And I was like, "Well, I'm gonna go get some food. I'm starving." And he was like, "You know, it's really cold out there." And I was like, "Well, yeah, that's why I'm dressed like this. You know, duh." And he goes, "All right, well, good luck." I was like, "Okay, thanks." So here I go. I take like 3 steps outside, and the cold air hits my lungs like, I don't know, thousands of needles. I've started coughing and choking. I was like, "Oh my god, I can't breathe." So I come back inside, and here's the pilots staring at me laughing. And I'm like, "What in the world? Like, why is it that cold? I can't understand, like, that level of cold." And he's like, "Yeah, they have snacks here. Just get something here." So, lesson learned. That is way too cold to be going outside. I should have known, because earlier that same day we'd been chucking cups of hot water out of the airplane on the ground and watching them poof into ice crystals. No, that's so funny. Hot water. Look at the ice crystals. Freaking cold. Those are my 4, like, or 5, was that 5? I think it was 5. 5 most embarrassing moments from when I was a flight attendant. I do have another one that's pretty embarrassing that I just thought of. So I did not like flying a position, which is what we call the position who worked in first class. It wasn't my vibe. The passengers in the back of the plane are my people. I am a coach, ride or die type of flight attendant. I do not want to be up in first class. Do not put me up there. I will get eaten alive up there. It's just not my vibe. So I like to be in the back. But when you're on reserve, you don't get to pick. You get the position of the person who called out that you're replacing. So it's a luck of the draw. And I got called out for a position. So I'm already dreading it because I don't want to be up there. And I'm very nervous up there just because I don't like it. So I'm just extra nervous when I had to be up there. And I, just before takeoff, I realize there's a compartment. There's lots of compartments that have to be latched, but there's one kind of on the back wall across from you and behind you that I forgot. And I realized this right before takeoff, so I jump out of my seat and I go to flip the latches. So those are secured now. However, that the jump seats are retractable. They spring up and down when you stand up. And before I sat down, I forgot to put the seat back down. So I try to sit down, and of course, there's no seat. So I sit straight onto the floor. And my legs, I'm gonna skirt my legs, go up, and they're flinging everywhere. Because the plane at this point is taking off. So I'm trying to get up. I'm trying to regain my composure. And there's this guy in first class. And he is reading a newspaper. And he's literally sitting there. He's got this newspaper. He's reading it. He sees me fall. He just looks up. And then looks straight back down at his newspaper. Like, no change in his facial expression whatsoever. Literally, like, it never happened. He never mentioned it, nothing. Like, it was so funny. And I'm like horrified. My bottom is hurting so bad because I went straight down onto my tailbone. But yeah, that one was a doozy. I kind of blocked that out. I just remembered it now. So, one of my best flight attendant friends, I'll tell you a story, one of her most embarrassing moments. She wouldn't even be mad because she tells this story all the time, but so, it was during our first week, one of the first days that she was flying, and she was carrying a tray with drinks on it, and then she also had a red wine bottle on this tray because she was refilling people's glasses. This was in first class, and they had some turbulence, and the wine bottle tipped off the tray, and it went onto this woman sitting on an aisle seat in first class. The whole bottle just glug 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 all over this lady, which is why you don't carry wine bottles on a tray, you carry it in your hand, but of course when you're new, you don't know these things. So, my friend, she's horrified, right? She's thinking, oh my gosh, this lady's gonna freak out, right? The lady just looks at her and she goes, oh, I hated this suit, but it was so expensive, my husband wouldn't let me get rid of it. Now I can tell him it's ruined. Thank you so much. And I'm like, oh my gosh, like, that was so lucky. What are the chances she'd get this lady that's super cool? And this suit, by the way, was like a beige suit, like a light beige colored suit. So she's got this red wine, like, all over this beige colored suit. And this lady is just super chill. She's like, no big deal. Yeah, I've got clothes in my bag. Let's just throw this away right here. So, of course, like, the airline, you know, pays for dealing with that type of situation, whatever, dry cleaning or the cost of the suit if it's not dry cleanable. But, oh my gosh, poor thing. Can you imagine? Like, you're just watching this red wine go everywhere and you can't do anything. I had something kind of similar with a bottle of water, though. It was sitting on the cart, and we hit turbulence, and it tipped off the cart, and it went all over this guy, but he was super chill, too, and I'm sure it helps that it was just water. sleepy little dogs in here with me, snoring over there. Sorry about that. Just filling in my lips now.